Hello everyone. Today's talk is very personal to me, like all other talks that have preceded me, because it is dear to my heart. We tend to think of special needs and gifted as opposites. One that needs a lot of help while the other is gifted, those who are capable of taking care of themselves. The word itself, gifted, means that these children have abilities that the common people like us, we don't have. So why do they need help? We have a say as Lebanese, شاطر بدبر حاله والشاطر ما بده مساعدة والشاطر شاطر وين ما كان. So why do they need help? However, today I want to share with you the opposite, that they do need our help. My son, my eldest son, was able to run a computer at the age of one. By three, he had developed a moral sense of right and wrong, just and unjust. And by four, he was able to add, subtract, and multiply. By five, he knew all that needs to be known about Sedna. And by seven, he was able to inform me about Sedna, the outer space planetoid that we could detect through its gravitational pull. And a piece of information that I flaunted to my students, who were very impressed with their instructor. She knows a lot. Now, although he was very smart, but he could not tolerate noise. He could handle any mathematical equation you could give him or any complex text. Yet, when it came to parties or noise or concerts, he could not handle it. This was fine with me because no concert, no birthday parties, no expenses. I saved myself a lot of money. However, this attitude started causing problems for him at school. In KG, he would go to the corner and cover his ears whenever his classmates sang or spoke in a loud voice. He would read by himself, excluding himself from others. When an idea got to him, he had to share it. He wanted to share it. He had the urge to go and take it and blurt it out, even though the teacher would not give him a permission. And other times, he would go to the corner, his reading favorite corner, 5 minutes into the class, because he had already understood the concept while his friends were still struggling. And then it would make him very frustrated that he had already grasped and wondered why his classmates are still struggling with it. How come they don't understand what's going on? Now, these children, these gifted children, feel things very intensely. They experience what Dabrowski calls as overexcitabilities. Dabrowski is a Polish psychiatrist and psychologist. He explained that these children have high levels of energy and at many times are misdiagnosed as ADHD, since the behavior is very similar. For example, my son was a compulsive talker from the moment he woke up to the split second he sleeps, and then he had a lot of nervous tics. Or these children might suffer from heightened awareness of their senses. Like I said before, Hadi Aram hated noises, skipped parties, and musical concerts, and at one time even cried before my father when my father spoke in front of him with a very loud voice. These children could also have intense mind activities. They love to read, and they are very curious about everything. They ask questions a lot. And this used to drive my Hadi Aram's KG teachers mad. He would ask, why would the... okay. A gifted child, I'm sure. He would ask, how come the sea is blue where the water is colorless? Why should we do this? How come there's misery? Why? He also experienced emotional sensitivity, exceptional emotional sensitivity. Because of their strong OE, at times these children can be misdiagnosed as bipolar. At one time they're extremely happy, and at another time they go to the extreme end when they are extremely depressed, when they see misery around them. 3 years ago, All I had to do to make him walk with me in CAFA demonstration against domestic violence is to, for him to watch an interview done by one of the victim's mothers. And it was so easy. He walked and he made his brother walk with us too. These children also are at emotional risk. Because they possess information much, they process information much faster than us and can acquire much more information than their peers. It puts them at an emotional risk because they feel inadequate, they feel out of place, they cannot communicate with their friends and share their ideas with them. They are also at a risk because of their asynchronous development. You have kids who are gifted in one thing, but not necessarily in everything. You might have a gifted child who is brilliant in English, but does very badly in Arabic. So this discrepancy, this extreme difference, causes a lot of problem, along with their sense that they need to feel that they are perfect. It posits a lot of challenges because they feel that they are not perfect, they are inferior, they're not up to the standards. Now, most schools are not equipped to deal with these children. These children who could be in grade 2 yet do grade 8 or 9 mathematics and barely have legible handwriting, and at the same time, because of their asynchronous development, they can easily have tantrums of a 7-year-old. So what do we do with them? We don't know. Now, for these children, also, life is not easy, schooling is not easy, and it can be difficult for them. They want to share with their friends their knowledge. They want to share their experiences with them. They want to share their interests, but they cannot because they are at a different level. I asked once my son when he was 10 or 11, "Sweetie, why don't you go to the recess and play with your friends?" He looked at me and then said, "Mom, they're either running after the ball or they're talking about cars. I'm not interested in either." At that time, Hadi Aram was more into reading encyclopedias. So he could not communicate with his friends, nor his friends could communicate with him. And this, in turn, made him withdraw socially, okay? Like many other gifted children in his situation. Dabrowski calls it the theory of positive disintegration, where he says, for every individual, one of us, for us to develop and grow socially and emotionally, we need to consume that stage. We cover it, we complete it, and to complete it, we need to interact socially and emotionally with other peers. Now, being at a different level where people do not understand them, gifted children withdraw socially. And then most of them get stuck in that first level. The problem is, in a good scenario, in a regular scenario, you will have an introvert. In a bad scenario, you will have Dylan Klebold and Eric Harris, the Columbine shooters, who in 1999 shot 15 of their friends, injured 24 before killing themselves. These were known to be gifted, genius in mathematics. However, these were children who could not cope socially and emotionally with the pressures and their own problems. Imagine how the world would have become had they had the proper help they needed. Now, during grade 7 and 8, Hadi Aram had also difficult times. He was in a very dark place. He could not understand his classmates. His classmates could not communicate with him. So he was able to, he projected his dark status through drawing of skulls and daggers, and he was always angry. Thank God we were aware, my spouse and I were aware of that situation. I had started at that time my PhD, I was almost through half of it, so we knew what was going on, and with a lot of support and counseling and talking, he got over it. Now, another group of gifted children who need our help are the twice exceptional. These are the group who are both gifted and with some sort of a learning difficulty. Now, the problem with them is that they are very hard to pick, to pinpoint, simply because it is their, either their giftedness marks their disability or their disability marks their giftedness. Unfortunately, in most cases, it is the disability that is identified as school. So these children would be catered for being learning difficulty or disability, and their gifted ability is ignored. This makes them very frustrated because they feel that the system has failed them. A frustrated student is an angry learner. An angry learner is a learner who causes problems and troubles in the class. Such troubles at times make them expelled and drop out of school. For what I have said so far, we realize that we have to change how we look at schooling for these gifted. We need to change how we think about education. We need a system that is tolerant, that is creative, that challenges them, and so that we can cater for their needs. Such an educational system needs teachers who are well-trained to understand and pinpoint gifted children, who can provide activities that can cater for their social and emotional development, and at the same time, who can come up with lesson plans and activities that can challenge these children. The educational system itself has to have a flexible curriculum, and at times it should even allow us to accelerate these children. Currently in Lebanon, we are not allowed to accelerate a child. So imagine if you have a kid who is in grade 2 but mentally is in grade 5. What frustration would that child feel with? So far in Lebanon, we have been unable to care for our children because we do not know that they have problems. Half of the problem is solved when we are aware of it. And this is why we should raise awareness towards their needs, because we have a lot of gifted children out there who are fighting their little wars and little demons. For those who are asking about the future of Hadi Aram, Hadi Aram will be joining AUB engineering faculty next semester in the fall. Now, he's doing fine, as you might see, except that from time to time, he gets embarrassed by his mommy. What are mommies for? Thank you.